I might be worse off like if I get off the drugs because I just find some other coping mechanisms. Some people hurt themselves, hurt others far greater than drug use ever will. I mean, there are people that are addicted to cutting themselves, people that are addicted to hurting others. There is, you know, countless other ways to cope, and I think the ways I cope are at least only harming me, and I've been pretty safe with it. I don't want to die. I just want to deal with what I've
in this room, and we also don't necessarily to get into a public space and say the names. I mean, that's one of the horrible things about this crisis is people who have been so badly treated and discarded by society die in our neighborhood, and we barely have the chance to remember them and to grieve for them and love them because we know that each and every one of them made important contributions. So I'm going to pass it off to Tracy to lead us in that moment of silence.
Thank you. If everybody could please take off their hats. Like Diana said, that we do a moment of silence in the downtown east side in many organizations to remember people who have passed before us, people who in the drug wars, family, relatives, people who are institutions in hospitals, prisons. So if we could do a moment silence and call out the names that you guys remember, please. Charlie.
Andrew.
Richard.
Mark. Go on, Peter.
Ron.
Justin.
Yell them out.
Ooh.
Clifford. Brian.
Dwayne.
Houston. Alvin. Bingo.
Michael.
So let this moment of silence be for them and many more. All my relations, thank you.
Oh, to all my relations. So I'd like to say gay lacrosse to each and every one of you for coming, you know, to fight for your relatives. You know, thank you. You know, this is my cousin Rupert. This is his baby Keyston. Let's not forget 914, you know, innocent, pure lives were lost, you know, due to ignorance, due to judgment, due to stigma, you know, many reasons. This is our medicine we use to help heal. You know what the medicine best for you. You know the medicine that works. We don't need bureaucrats, you know, coming from a top-down approach to tell us how to live. You know, that's an answer that needs to come from this community, this group here. You know, we do our best to support you in your, because we know you love your relatives. So I just wanted to say that. We're just gonna sing a prayer song. Oh, my tummy.
About clothing and items and stuff like that. I just want to say, bring that awareness to this whole thing. We've got a group of people that are recovered or recovering, and like she was saying, he had 4 years, and then he slipped back into it with Kendall, and we lost him. So that's the reason why we're down here. Thank you.
It sounds like they're being stalled a little bit, but they are. are waiting for the manager of the Health Canada office so that they can deliver the demands to the manager, and then they're going to be right back down. And our plan is to leave through these doors here and march down Cordova back to Oppenheimer Park. So we have a little bit more open mic time while we wait for them to come down. Is that anybody else?
Take care of their own, go for their own, and you know, stuff the government should be doing, but we can't wait for them until we do it. Because with the whole prevention roads and stuff like that, we got our foot on the ground, and we see what's going on, so we just step up. And then the government likes to.
A representative of Health Canada, and judging from our response, there's going to be a need for more actions. More actions across the country, direct actions. Don't let this be the last day we go out here. We told Health Canada our demands and our demand to speak with Health Minister Phil Pyne. We have to keep the pressure on, though. This isn't done by a long shot. We have to continue to keep the pressure on. Thank you.
Organizing and mobilizing, as we know from social movements through history, they don't listen unless we're disruptive, right? So I want to thank the Canadian Association of People Who Use Drugs, VANDU, Culture Saves Lives, PHS, and all the other folks who helped WARS, everyone else who helped with organize the rally, and hopefully we can also bring those organizations and communities together to plot further actions to push this and treat it like the emergency that it is. So we're gonna head back now to Oppenheimer Park, where I think there's gonna be a process of hanging these feathers that we've been carrying on the march to memorialize the over 914 folks that we lost this year. So we're gonna leave out through these doors if we can get the banners to lead again and then get people to follow. And